गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स.
गुड मॉर्निंग सर.
सो यस्टरडे वी हैव डन विद योर इंपल्स. इज द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ इंपल्स क्लियर फॉर एवरीवन? बेटा, व्हाट इज एन इंपल्स? आई टोल्ड यू यस्टरडे, इंपल्स इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय JRI. इंपल्स इज नथिंग बट फोर्स एक्टिंग ऑन एनी बॉडी फॉर अ स्मॉल इंटरवल ऑफ अ टाइम इज नोन एज ऑफ योर इंपल्स. I इज इक्वल्स टू इंटीग्रल ऑफ योर F इनटू DT, और इंटीग्रल ऑफ योर DP इज नथिंग बट ऑफ योर P. इंपल्स इज ऑल्सो इक्वल टू वॉट? चेंज इन मोमेंटम और फोर्स इन टू योर टाइम. Antena, is it clear for everyone?
Yes, sir.
Chalo, let us try to go for the next one. Applications of Newton's first second law. Applications of Newton's second law. Can anyone tell me what is a Newton's second law, beta? What is Newton's second law?
F net is equal to mass into acceleration.
Yeah, force is equals to rate of change of momentum dp by over dt, or that is equals to mass into acceleration. So this is the force. Newton's second law is nothing but rate of change of your momentum is known as of your Newton's second law's application part of relations. Is that clear for everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. इसी पे हम लोग एप्लीकेशन कर लेंगे बेटा. न्यूटन से सेकंड लॉ, इफ आई एम राइटिंग राइट नाउ, फोर्स इज इक्वल्स टू डीपी बाय डीटी और एस इक्वल्स टू एफ इज इक्वल्स टू एम इनटू योर ए पार्ट ऑफ रिलेशन. सी द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इन दिस वन. से फॉर एग्जांपल, इफ आई एम सेइंग यू ए 30 ग्राम बुलेट इनिशियली ट्रैवलिंग एट 120 meter per second penetrates 12 centimeter into a wooden block. 12 centimeter into a wooden block. First off, the average resistance, exerted By wooden block is. Can anyone try to do it out? Direct application better. See, whatever the data he has given, you just write the data. A 30 gram bullet right now we are having a 30 gram of your bullet initially traveling at your 120 meter per second. So initial velocity is equal to how much for me? 120 meter per second. Penetrates 12 centimeter into a wooden block. The average resistance exerted by the wooden block is equal to how much? Like, say this is your wooden block, एक block है यहाँ पर इस तरह से, और यहाँ this is your bullet which is been passing into this one. Bullet का mass दे रखा है for me. Mass is given how much for me? Mass of your bullet is equals to 30 grams. So that is equals to 30 into 1 gram is 10 to the power of minus 3 kg. Okay, and it is been penetrating in this one. So it is penetrating in this one. So this is your initial velocity and final velocity after penetrating a distance of your x. The final velocity is becoming for me zero. So the average resistance exerted by the wooden block. Agar this bullet is going inside and stopping, means this wooden block is exerting the opposite force on that one. So that opposite force, how much is asking right now for the given condition? Is it clear for everyone? Is the question clear for everyone?
Yes, sir.
Isn't it? So what is the distance he has been traveling right now? It is telling 12 centimeters. That means x is equals to 12 centimeters. So convert that one also into meters. So this is 12 into 10 to the power of your minus 2 meters, because 1 centimeter is 10 to the power of minus 2 meters per deflation. Initial velocity is equals to 120 meter per second. This is SI system, and final velocity is zero. Final velocity is equals to for me zero. Is it clear? Then apply the Newton's second law. F is equals to m into your a. Mass is there, acceleration is not there. How do you get the acceleration? Newton's, from the equations of motion, v square minus u square is equals to 2a into your s. Final velocity is zero minus of u square is equals to 2. Acceleration is retarding into your x. Okay, so from this one, acceleration is how much? A is equals to this minus sign gets cancelled. A is equals to u square by 2 into your x. Clear for everyone? So this force will become for me F is equals to your, or else you can even use this relation better directly. F is equals to your M into your A. A value is equals to how much for me? U square by 2 times of your X part of relation. So mass is how much for me? 30 grams. So 30 into 10 to the power of minus 3 into velocity is given how much for me? 120. So it is 120 into 120 square. And that is the reason. Divided by 2 into your x. X value is given how much for me in the problem? You see 12 centimeters. So that is equals to 12 into 10 to the power of minus 2. See how what I am the answer I am getting right now for anyone? This is 12 1z. This is 12 10z. 10 to the power of minus 2 है ये तो ये ऊपर चले जाएगा तो प्लस हो जाएगा 2 1s 2 6s 3 2s 3 18 so 18 बोलो तो power कितना आ रहा देखो this is 10 to the power of 3 this will also will get cancelled so कितना आ रहा देखो anyone make it fast कितना आ रहा Are you there, everyone?
18,000 10 to the power of minus.
Beta, ye dekho 30 into 60. 3 6 is 18. So, kitna ho gaya? 18 into ye ho gaya 10 to the power of minus 3, isn't it?
Correct.
Into 10 to the power of plus 3. So, ye do chale gaya, beta. So, kitna hua? 1,800 newton. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Chalo. Next question. A body under the action of a force, F bar is equals to 6 I cap minus 8 J cap plus your 10 K cap. acquires an acceleration of 1 meter per second square. First of all, the mass of this body must be. See the question. A body under the action of a force. Force is given as 6 I cap minus 8 J cap plus 10 K cap acquires an acceleration of 1 meter per second square. The mass of the body will be equal to your how much? Can anyone? Again, Newton's second law lagana apne ko directly. Force is given how much for me? According to Newton's second law, force is equals to your mass into your acceleration. Okay, force is given for me. F is equal to how much for me? 6 into I cap minus 8 into J cap plus of your 10 into your K cap. Magnitude of this force is equal to how much for me? Under root of your. This one is of your 6 square plus 8 square plus 10 square. Kitna aara dekho ye pura? 6 is a 36, 8 is a 64. This one is 6 is a 36 plus 8 into 8, 8 is a 64 plus ये हो गया 100 तो कितना हो गया root 200 means for me 10 root 2 newton is nothing but of your force. Acceleration is given as 1 meter per second square in the problem. Is asking mass is equals to how much? So from this one mass is equals to, how do you write? Mass is equals to force by area. Force is how much I got? 10 into root 2 divided by acceleration. Acceleration is how much for me? 1. So what is an answer for me? 10 root 2 kg will be the answer. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Chalo, very good. Next question, you see, beta. Very good question. A stone is dropped from a height h. It hits the ground with a certain momentum that is nothing but P. piston. If same stone is dropped from a height 100% more than the previous height, the momentum 100% more than the previous height, the momentum when it hits the ground will be. First one is 68%, second one is 41%, third one is 200%. Fourth one is 100%. See the question carefully, wait everyone. Both easy question hai. Try kar liye ek baar. Stone is dropped from a height h. Pehle diagram draw kar lijiye beta. The way you are understanding, you try to draw the diagram for this one. Ye ho gaya ground yahan par, and a ball is dropped right now from here. Dropped from a height h. So yahan se ye drop kiya gaya hua h. To iski initial velocity kitni ho jayegi? Zero. It hits the ground with a certain momentum. So when it is hitting the ground, iska momentum kitna hai? P. If the same stone is dropped from a height 100% of more, yani yahan se 100% more matlab kitna ho jayega iska height yahan se yahan tak, so ye height ho jayega mere paas 2h, then the previous height, then the momentum when it hits the ground, yani yahan par momentum ho gaya p dash. Momentum same rahega ya different rahega beta, kyunki ball to same hai lekin height change ho rahi hai. Dekhiye 100% more ho gaya, 100% of more of h matlab kitna 2h na. So stone is dropped from a height h, it hits the ground with a certain momentum p. If same stone is being dropped from a height 100% more than the previous height, the momentum when it hits the ground will be equal to your how much? Okay, you know that when a body is been dropping from a certain height, what is the velocity? V square minus u square is equals to 2 into a into your s. Final velocity is how much for me? Initial velocity is zero. With what velocity it will be hitting the ground? V square is equals to 2 into g into your h. Yani velocity on striking the ground is how much? 2g into your h beta.
Yes sir.
So velocity with which it is hitting the ground is v is equals to under root of 2g into h. Now tell me momentum. Initial momentum is how much for me? Initial momentum is m into v. That means mass is same, but velocity is under root of 2g into your h. Then next momentum, that is nothing but p final is equals to mass is same, velocity is different, so it is m into under root of your 2g into your h will become double of that one, 100% more, 2h. Now what is asking right now? What is the value of your percentage change? That means if I am taking right now p final by your p initial is equals to in dono ka ratio le lo, so it is m into under root of your 2g into your h into this one is nothing but root 2 divided by m into your root 2 into g into your h. This one gets cancelled, so this one is how much? Root 2. So I can write here p final is equals to root 2 times of your p initial. So I can write here p final is equals to 1.414 times of your p initial. P final is equals to 1.414 times of your P initial. So percentage change is how much for me? Percentage change is equals to P final minus P initial divided by your P initial into 100. Kabhi bhi percentage nikalna hai, final minus initial divided by initial into 100. This is a constant formula beta. Whenever, wherever, complete physics mein aapko percentage nikalna hai, percentage change is equals to final momentum minus initial momentum divided by initial momentum into 100. Is it clear for everyone? A percentage nikalo. Percentage change is equals to your P2 minus of P1. P2 is how much Amagat we got right now? Root 2. That means 1.414 times of your P initial minus of your P initial divided by P initial into 100. Kuch karte bhi dikhai de raha beta? P initial gets cancelled. 1.414 minus 1 into your 100. So this one will be 0.414 into your 100. तो परसेंटेज में ले ले तो कितना आ रहा, इनटू 100 कर लो, सो दिस विल कम आउट फॉर मी 41%. इज इट क्लियर फॉर एवरीवन? देख लो एक बार जल्दी से, एक कोई डाउट रहा तो प्लीज लेट मी नो.
यस सर क्लियर है.
पक्का?
यस सर
पक्का सर क्लियर है.
वेरी गुड. Next one is concept of Newton's third laws of motion. Newton's third law of motion. I hope everyone might have been knowing this one better from your school days. You have been coming across the Newton's third law. So tell me in one word, what is a Newton's third law? Anyone? What is a Newton's third law, beta? To every action,
for every action there is equal and opposite.
Very good. To every action there is always an equal and opposite reaction. Is it clear? To every action there is an equal and opposite reaction part of relation. Okay, that means force exerted by your A on your B will be equal to, opposite means minus, force exerted by your B on your A. ठीक है? कोई खींच के अगर आपको चाटा मारे तो एक्शन और रिएक्शन क्या हो जाएगा? दो डिफरेंट बॉडीज पे होगा और इफेक्ट भी क्या हो रहा है? डिफरेंट बॉडीज पे कंडीशन पे हो रहा है राइट नाउ. सो फोर्स एक्सर्टेड बाय ए ऑन योर बी इज इक्वल्स टू minus of force exerted by your B on your A part of relation, isn't it? And they always occurs in pairs, beta. Ye aisa nahi hai ki they always occurs in the condition. So force always occurs in pairs, and they act on the two different bodies, isn't it? Action reaction acts on what, beta? Two different bodies. I can say right now here, action and reaction forces act on different bodies but not on same bodies. Newton's third law mein kya ho raha hai? One body will exert the force on other body which is equal and opposite part of relation. Is that point clear for everyone? This is very important, beta. Action and reaction are acting on two different bodies but not on the same. Is it clear? Is it clear? Is it clear, beta? Action and reaction forces are acting on two different bodies. Like say, this is one body, this is your another body. This is A and this is your B. A will exert the force on your B, F1, and B will exert the same amount of the force or maybe opposite amount of the force on this one. Now see this, F1 and F2 are acting on two different bodies, but not on the same bodies. Okay, so that is the reason we can't add them basically. Can we add them, beta? Because both of them are opposite. We can't add them because they will get cancelled if their forces are equal part. If the two forces are acting on the body in the same direction, then only we can add them. Otherwise, we can't add them for the given condition. Clear, eh?
Sir.
Yes, sir.
So this one was about your Newton's third law statement. Let us try to take the application of this one. See how we are doing the applications of this one. एक मिनट बेटा. yeah sorry chalo applications dekho beta first application of this one is number 1 a machine gun fires n bullets per second with a speed u and mass of each bullet is m. Okay, the force required to keep the gun stationary is like say ये अपनी gun है so from here when a bullet is being fired 1, 2, 3 like that n number of bullets are being fired from this okay so when n number of bullets are being fired each of mass m moving with velocity u mass of this gun is capital m now see this one a machine gun fires n bullets per second yani total number of bullets per second n by t is represented by small m ye yaad rakho beta n is nothing but number of bullets by time number of bullets per time is represented by small n represents me what bullets per second is it clear this point capital n by t is nothing but what beta n particulation a force dekho f is equals to your force acting on this one is dp by dt okay so that will be equal to how much for me p is nothing but of your m into v particulation I can write so this is nothing but of your d this one is m into v by your t okay how many number of bullets n number of bullets n into t for this one is see mass is constant right now m v is also constant right now this one is dn by your dt number of bullets per second number of bullets per second is how much for me n so I can write this force is equal to how much for me this force is equals to right now for me n into m into your v particulation so force required to keep it in the stationary will be equal to how much for me n into m into v or else I can write this one f is equals to capital N into m into v divided by your time part of your relation I can even write like this clear for everyone see the statement once again beta a machine gun is firing n bullets per second and u with the initial speed is u and mass of each bullet is nothing but m then the force required to keep the gun stationary will be equal to how much force acting on that one is nothing but what from the Newton's second law dp by dt momentum is m into v m and v are right now for me right now constant with what velocity they are been moving out so number of bullets are been changing so dn by dt this dn by dt is nothing but of your n for small change so f is equals to n into m into v by t or f is equals to n into m into your v part of your relation is the statement clear for everyone so force required to keep the machine gun stationary is equals to what is the formula f is equals to n into m into v what is n here n is equals to your number of bullets fired per second clear for everyone
yes sir.
Chalo next one dekho ye bhi bata lo ek bar like say for example bullets are moving with a speed v hit a wall so case number 1 in this one ये देखो यहां पर ड्रॉ कर रहा हूं ये हो गया मेरे पास वॉल सो दिस वन इज योर वॉल एंड दिस इज योर बुलेट मास एम मूविंग विद वेलोसिटी से फॉर एग्जांपल वी ओके सी बुलेट्स आर बीन मूविंग विद ए स्पीड वी हिट ए वॉल सो नाउ कंडीशन इज व्हेन द बुलेट comes to rest in wall force on wall is how much can anyone tell me force on the wall by the bullets will be equal to how much for me? N number of bullets, M into V. बताइए ना न्यूटन लॉ इक्वल एंड ऑपोजिट, ये जितना फोर्स एग्जर्ट करेगा वॉल भी उतनी ही फोर्स ऑपोजिट डायरेक्शन में एग्जर्ट करेगा. सो इफ दे आर फोर्सेस आर सेम देन दिस बॉडी विल बी कमिंग टू द रेस्ट इन द वॉल पार्ट. सो फोर्स एग्जर्टेड ऑन द वॉल विल बी इक्वल टू हाउ मच फॉर मी? एन नंबर ऑफ बुलेट्स, मास ऑफ द बुलेट इनटू वेलोसिटी विद व्हिच इट इज बीन मूविंग. क्लियर?
यस सर.
नाउ इफ आई टेक ऑपोजिट केस ऑफ दिस वन, when the bullets rebound elastically force on wall. दो मिनट रुक लेता हूं बेटा. ठीक है बेटा, ये देखो बेटा हम लोग क्या बात कर रहे थे. व्हेन बुलेट्स आर मूविंग विद अ स्पीड वी एंड विल हिट द वॉल. सो व्हेन द बुलेट कम्स टू द रेस्ट इन द वॉल, फोर्स ऑन द वॉल विल बी इक्वल टू हाउ मच फॉर मी? एन इनटू एम इनटू योर वी, एन इनटू एम इनटू योर वी पार्ट. इफ इट इज स्टिकिंग इनटू दिस वन, इफ इट इज रीबाउंडिंग द बुलेट विल हिट दिस वन, एंड इफ दिस वॉल इज लाइक ए मेटल पाइप विच इज एक्जैक्टली नॉट पेनिट्रेटिंग लाइक ए बुलेट प्रूफ और समथिंग लाइक दैट, इट विल हिट इट एंड कमिंग बैक इन द बैकवर्ड डायरेक्शन. सो द वेलोसिटीज आर इन ऑपोजिट डायरेक्शन. So two velocities are in opposite direction. So what happens to the momentum? Momentum will become for me two times, isn't it? Change in momentum is how much beta? If initial momentum is nothing but p, final momentum is also p, but in opposite direction. So change in momentum will be how much for me? 2p, na? So this is nothing but two times of your p. So it is equal to two times of your m into n into your v part affiliation. So force exerted by the wall, if it is rebounding, that will become for me two times of your m into n into your v part affiliation. Is it clear for everyone? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
चलो.
Yes, sir. Clear.
So, एक question देख लो बेटा इस पे यहाँ पर. Say for example, we got a machine gun. Say for example, a machine gun is mounted. A machine gun is mounted on a 200 kg vehicle. On a 200 kg vehicle, on a horizontal smooth road. Smooth road means no friction. The gun fires 10 bullets per second. 10 bullets per second with a velocity of 500 meter per second, beta. If the mass of each bullet is 10 grams, what is the acceleration produced in the vehicle? What is the acceleration produced in vehicle? Okay, options given are 25 centimeter per second square. Second one is 30 centimeter per second square. Third one is 50 centimeter per second square. And fourth one is 50 centimeter, 150 centimeter per second square. Chalo. See the question once again, beta, everyone. Read the question carefully and try to analyze it. A machine gun is being mounted on what? 200 kg vehicle. Vehicle ka mass hai 200 kg and in a horizontal smooth surface. The gun fires 10 bullets per second. The gun fires 10 bullets per second with a velocity of 500 meter per second. If the mass of each bullet is 10 grams, this is CGS system, you need to convert them. What is the acceleration produced with one? Now tell me, what is the momentum of each bullet when you are firing it, beta? Momentum of each bullet will be equal to how much? Momentum of each bullet that is equals to mass into your velocity. Mass is how much for me? 10 grams. 10 into 10 to the power of minus 3 into velocity. Velocity is your 500, isn't it? So that means this will become for me how much? Can anyone tell me? 2, this one is 3. This one will get cancelled. So this comes out for me 5 kg meter per second. So this is your momentum. Okay. Now force due to 10 bullets per second is nothing but what? F is equals to N into dP by over dt. Isn't it? That means I can write here right now what for me? N number of bullets for me. N by t is nothing but how much for me? A small n into M into your V part. Isn't it? So what will be the relation right now for me? Force. Number of bullets are how much for me? 10. M into V is nothing but what? Momentum. So it is N into P I can write. So N is equal to how much better? Number of bullets is given how much for me? Number of bullets firing per second is how much for me? 10 bullets per second. That means this N by T is nothing but 10 into momentum is nothing but 5. So force is equals to 50 newton. Once I know the force, I can calculate the acceleration better. I'm writing acceleration here. So acceleration is equals to force by mass. Force is how much for me? 50. Mass is how much for me? 200. Mass of what? Acceleration, this is for your vehicle. This means this is the mass of your vehicle. Mass of your vehicle is how much for me? 200. So this one will get cancelled right now for me. So it is 5 by 20. That means that will become for me how much? 5 by 20. Na? Mass is given for me 200. So it is 1 by 4. And 1 by 4 is nothing but equal to 0.25. That means in centimeters, if I am writing, this will come out for me 0.25 meters per second square. If it is in centimeters, that will become for me 25 centimeter per second square. Is it clear here? Be careful here, beta. Here, this is the acceleration of vehicle. Acceleration of the vehicle means we need to take the mass of your vehicle. Mass of vehicle is how much for me? 200 kg. So that is the reason mass of vehicle is 200 kg. So 5 by 20, 1 by 4, that is nothing but equal to 25 centimeter per second square. Is it clear for everyone?
Yes, sir.
I'll change it right now.
Swimming is because of which law, beta? First law, second law, third law? Swimming is because of which law?
Third law.
Newton's third law. Because you exert the force in one direction and your body will be moving in the opposite direction. So swimming is possible due to the third law motion
Newton's
of your body.
Newton's third law.
Newton's third law part of relation. Is that clear for everyone? Rocket engine, flying of a rocket. When
Newton's
you fire from Thierry Cota, that is also Newton's third law. Because when the rocket is been firing, I'll show you this one. See, when the rocket is been firing, see this one better. Recoiling of this gun in this one also. This is also because of which law, you see? Third law. One body is moving in the front direction. Reaction of the gun is in the opposite. So recoiling of the gun is also because of which law, beta? Newton's third law. Even rocket propulsion. See here, right? When rocket is moving in the upward direction, the gas ejections are in the downward direction right now. Because of this downward force only, the rocket is being pushed in the upward direction. So this is also because of which law for me? Newton's third law. Recoiling of the gun. Recoiling of a gun is also because of your Newton's third law. Bullets are moving in the front direction. Gun is recoiling in the backward direction. This is because of your Newton's third laws of your motion. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Sure. Next one is concept of variable mass. Concept of variable mass. Variable mass matlab kya beta? What do you mean by variable mass?
Different masses.
Different masses. That means mass is changing with respect to time. Maan ke chalo, for example, there is a tanker which is carrying like 5,000 liters of water and it has to go from the water tank to your some building to deliver this much amount of water. If there is a small hole in the tank of your, what do you call that one, tanker, then by the time it reaches it to the building, will it be remaining 5,000 or will it be changing? Huh? 5,000 of liters of water is present in this one and this trolley or this truck is moving in the front direction. There is a small hole. So water is continuously falling in the downward direction. By the time it reaches to the building, the water in the tank may be some 4,500 liters only, or maybe 4,700 liters. That means mass is continuously changing with respect to time. Isn't it? Is it?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Isn't it? That is of your variable mass. Even rocket, if you might have been seeing the rocket launching anytime, the rocket when it is being launched, the basic component of a rocket, if I'm taking right now for the given condition, this means n number of gases object hote hain. There are one or another part of relation right now. Yahan par ek another part hota hai, aur iske upar aur ek minjan hota hota hai. The moment it has been fired, every stage what happened, one part will get detached. The moment when it enters into the orbit, this is only the amount of the satellite which is revolving around the Earth. If this is your Earth, Earth ke alawa jo satellite revolve karta hai, so this is the small part of the satellite which has been revolving. But when you are sending it from the surface of the Earth, it is some like 10,000 tons, very huge amount. Now, in order to lift this huge amount of rocket, very huge amount of gases have been propelled in the backward direction. Aapne isse pehle dekho animation. Kitna amount of gas bahar nikal raha hai. Lot amount of gases have been coming out. Then only this is pushing this body to move in the upward direction. So before the gases ejection, इसका वेट मान के चलो 10,000 टन्स होगा, इजन इट? तो जैसे गैस एजेक्ट हो जाएगा शायद ये 9,000 टन को आ जाए, है कि नहीं?
Yes, sir.
Isn't it? So what is happening right now? Gas molecules are completely coming out right now. So at every stage right now, what is happening? Mass of that body is continuously changing. So this is also one of the best example for your, this is also one of the best example for your variable mass, where mass is continuously changing with respect to your time. So the body which changes the mass with respect to the time is called as of what? Variable mass is called as of your variable mass part of a relation. Isn't it? See here right now, I can write that statement. When a certain mass leaves or enters a system with certain velocity with respect to system, that is, we write it as u relative. It exerts a force on the system. It exerts a force on the system, which is called a thrust force, and is defined as, see here, F thrust is equals to U relative into your mass is changing with respect to time. So it is dm by dt. तो ये हो गया इसका फॉर्मूला फॉर वेरिएबल मास के लिए. जो फॉर्मूला हम लोग लगाएंगे, व्हाट इज द फॉर्मूला? F thrust is equals to U relative into dm by your dt part of relation. U relative किसे बोलते हैं? Please try to understand this topic, very important beta. U relative is nothing but what? Velocity of your variable mass with respect to your system. And dm by dt is nothing but what, beta? Can anyone tell me what is dm by dt? Dm by dt is known as what? Rate of change of mass with respect to the time part of relation. Is it clear for everyone? Is the variable mass concept clear for everyone? It's khali introduction hai, definition nahi bataya maine. Iska application bahut zyada bada hai basically. So I'm doing right now the concept of variable mass. What do you mean by variable mass? When a certain mass leaves or enters a system with a certain velocity with respect to it, it exerts a force on the system which is called as of your thrust force, and is defined as of what? F thrust is equals to U relative into dm by dt. U relative is equal to beta velocity of variable mass with respect to system. ये याद रखना है, compulsory problems करते से time पे. U relative is nothing but what? U relative is velocity of variable mass with respect to your system part of relation. Is it clear for everyone, beta?
Yes, sir.
चलो, एक छोटा सा question करो इस पे, then we'll try to go for the application of this one. Say for example, a Diwali rocket is ejecting 50 gram of gases at a velocity of 400 meter per second. First of all, the accelerating force on the rocket will be, first one is 22 dyne, second one is 20 dynes, third one is 20 dynes, and fourth one is 100.
Is the first option?
How much better?
The first option, sir.
see it. आया किसी को? Am I audible? So Diwali rocket has been ejecting 50 grams. Convert this one. Mass is equals to 50 grams. So that will be equal to 50 into 10 to the power of minus 3 kg per second. Yeah, 20 newtons aayega. Mass is this much and velocity is given how much for me? V is equals to 400 meter per second. So what is the F thrust ka formula? F thrust is equals to U relative into your dm by your dt. This one is given as what? Dekho, 50 grams of a gas at a velocity of 400 meter per second is ejecting. Ejecting means dm by dt. Pura dm by dt. This is your dm by your dt is equals to your 50 into 10 to the power of minus 3 kg per your second. So U relative is how much for me? How much for me here right now? 400 into dm by dt is how much for me? 50 into 10 to the power of minus 3. A3, A2 zeros, A3 chalega. 4, 5 is 20. So you have 20 newtons. Must be the answer for that one. Aya sabhi ko?
Yes, sir.
Clear?
Yes, sir.
Chalo. One more question dekh lo. Iska bhi answer bata do jaldi se. In a rocket, of mass 1000 kg fuel is consumed at a rate of 40 kg per second. First off, the velocity of the gases ejected from the rocket is 5 into 10 to the power of 4 meter per second. First off, the thrust on rocket is chalo jaldi se batao. Direct formula. Yeah. F is equals to U into dm by dt beta. Isn't it? U is given how much for me? The velocity of gases ejected from the rocket is 5 into 10 to the power of 4 into mass is nothing but how much for me? Dm by dt is given how much for me right now? Can anyone tell me what is dm by dt? A rocket of mass 1000 kg fuel is being consumed at the rate of 40 kg per second. 40 rate means what? Mass per second, dm by dt. So this will be equal 40. To 40. So how much will it be? 4, 5 is 20 into 10 to the power of 5. So this 20 means 2 will go. 2 into 10 to the
power, 10 to the power of 6.
Aya sabhi ko?
Yes.
Chalo, I see everything, but a new iske andar questions, almost all basic wale questions jo bante hai na. नीट के लिए ऐसे वाले क्वेश्चंस बनते हैं, इससे ज्यादा कुछ ज्यादा डिफिकल्ट नहीं होते. इसका डेरिवेशन है वो ज्यादा डिफिकल्ट है, वो भी मैं आपको बता दूंगा, बट स्टिल यू कैन डू इट आउट राइट नाउ. नेक्स्ट वन इज, इफ फोर्स ऑन योर रॉकेट हैविंग एग्जॉस्ट वेलोसिटी ऑफ 300 मीटर पर सेकेंड 300 meter per second is 210 newton. Then rate of combustion of fuel is 0.7 kg per second. Number 2, 1.4 kg per second. Number 3, 0.07 kg per second. And fourth one is 10.7 kg per second. Jaldi se batao. Beta, maybe from tomorrow or day after tomorrow, I'm coming to the campus because I'm having holidays in the campus of Narayana for 4 days. for 2 or 3 days I'll be available for you at the campus. If you are having any doubts or if you're not understand any topics, you please compulsorily come to personally to the institution. I'll try to sit there. I'll try to help you out with all the doubts which you have been having. And even if the concepts, if you are not understand anything, you please try to come in personally to the institution. I'll be available for there exclusively for you students, especially for the juniors. For 2 hours, I'll be giving the time. And for the other students, I'll be giving the 2 hours time there basically. I'll tell you on what day exactly I'm coming. Most probably, I may be coming from tomorrow or day after tomorrow. I'll let you know before I come there, one day before I come to the institution. Is it clear? Even in kinematics, me, Newton's laws, me, agar koi part aap logo samajh mein nahi aaya, you can come to the institution. I'll sit personally with you and try to help you out with the concepts. Okay? Chalo. Iska answer bata do jaldi se. If the force on a rocket having an exhaust velocity of 300 meter per second, that means U is equals to 300 meter per second part of relation, exerts a force. Force is equals to how much beta? 210 Newton. Then rate of combustion of the fuel, ante dm by dt is how much is asking. You already know the formula. F is equals to U relative into your dm by your dt. That means I can write here dm by your dt is equals to F by your U relative. So force is how much for me? 210. By U relative is how much for me? 300. So ye chalega, ye chalega. So that is nothing but 21 divided by 30. So kitna aa raha dekho beta approximately. So dm by dt is equals to 21 divided by 30 approximately.
0.7
kg per second. Kg per second. Aa gaya sabhi ko? Theek hai?
Yes sir.
So I hope that you got an idea. Maybe tomorrow or day after tomorrow, make a session that you come to the campus from morning to evening and bring the tiffins along with you so that I can spend some time with all of you and have your doubts clarification and also help you out in what to do, what not to do. And even the previous topic, jo bhi aap log ke ho gaye hain, agar aap log ke usme andar bhi koi doubt se ya koi topic chhut gaya ho, then please try to come with your all your material, whichever you are having, so that I can help you out with all the basics required for you. Theek hai? I'll let you know by today evening better, because mere ko college mein holidays abhi declare nahi hue. Today night tak declare hoga. Agar if it is declaring today night, maybe tomorrow along with Ali sir, I'll be there in the campus. Theek hai?
Ji sir.
Okay, chalo. And please try to spend your time full day in the campus and bring along with you your complete lunch so that you can spend the time from morning to evening, from morning 9 o'clock to evening 5 o'clock takka, with all precautionary measures you try to come to the campus so that we can sit and we can have all the doubts clarification for 2 days exclusively for the physics. No chemistry, no biology. Again, I'm telling you, if I'm coming on that day, you should give you complete time only for physics, because I may not be available again for your regular days. So please make sure of that. You will be doing only the physics for the 2 days and you'll be coming with only the physics books for the 2 days to the campus. Is that clear?
Yeah.
Okay, chalo then. Take care. Bye, beta.
Bye.